My guest today is Stephen Phillips, the Director General of Invest Hong Kong. Welcome, Stephen. Your primary role as head of Invest Hong Kong is to attract global business to Hong Kong. I want to talk to you about where you see opportunities today for global business people with Hong Kong and how they can access those opportunities by utilizing the services of Invest Hong Kong. But first, I want to talk to you about the risk assessment that international businessmen would need to take, keeping in mind the recent protests against new regulations in Hong Kong and also the fallout of the global pandemic. So how do you see the situation in Hong Kong today, keeping in mind these two factors?
Well, firstly, thank you for the opportunity to have the discussion today. You're certainly right that for inward investment agencies around the world, the COVID-19 pandemic has created an incredibly challenging environment, not least because business people haven't been able to travel as they need to do when they're making investments. And of course, Hong Kong hasn't been immune from that. We've been fortunate in terms of good control of the outbreak, but we have pretty much closed the borders to have that public health control. So, like many places, what we have seen is certain sectors particularly hard hit, hospitality, retail, food and drink, for instance. That said, a number of other sectors, which Hong Kong is well known for, have been quite buoyant. As one of the world's international financial centres, the financial markets have continued to perform strongly. So the banks, the asset managers, the insurers have been doing okay, and all of the related professional services. And we've also seen a lot of activity in the innovation and startup space. So it's a mixed picture, but it's certainly challenging, primarily because people can't move and therefore consequently they can't hire people, they can't find premises, or all of those very practical things.
I want to go into the opportunities in just a moment, but before that, let me just talk about the risk factors, because that's an important part for a businessman or even an investor, especially an investor. How do you see the current situation? Is it getting better? Because you did see protests in the past, and this one country, two systems was under pressure, or that is at least what people felt, that there was a backlash to certain things that happened in Hong Kong with regard to regulation. So how do you see the current situation?
You're right that Hong Kong obviously saw in 2019 the very violent protests on the streets. The good news is that things are back to the normal calm of Hong Kong. But of course, those images that people saw so vividly has affected some of the thinking of investors who haven't been able to travel to Hong Kong recently. What I can say, really based upon the data that we look at, though, is that the business community continues to be very robust. So we do a survey every year looking at the international and mainland business community in Hong Kong. And in 2020, the number of companies was only 15 different to 2019. So somewhat over 9,000.
But in fact, you have had problems even recently, and you are of the opinion that a lot of that is now in the past. How do you look at the recent situation? Because one can't say that the problem is completely over. Do you think that would have an effect on trade investment, especially into Hong Kong?
For sure, the geopolitical situation globally, particularly with US-China tensions, sees Hong Kong within that debate. One of the consequences of the social unrest that we saw was the introduction of a national security law in Hong Kong very similar to national security laws around the world. That is part of what has restored law and order and tranquility to the streets. When I talk to businesses, whether they're based here in Hong Kong or around the world, they actually welcome that, because obviously businesses don't want that risk, as you've alluded to. They'd like to find ways to risk mitigate rather than take on additional risk. So I think that's a very different perspective that businesses have, perhaps to some of the political and in some quarters, the media narrative. There's some changes taking place in terms of the election system in Hong Kong. But again, from a business point of view, that isn't something that businesses have been raising as a concern with me. So I think, like any business, when you're thinking about investing, you've got to dig deeper, go beyond the headlines and look at the real facts, the real reality, talk to people on the ground, and take broad counsel rather than just listening to sound bites that might be accompanied with certain fairly livid images.
I think businesses need to do a risk assessment for themselves, because they have their own needs and their own appetite for risk. So that would be one part. And then the second part, of course, is that they would need to assess the opportunities that exist and try and explore and see if they're appropriate for them. So let's move to the areas now of trade and investment. Where do you see specific opportunities? And I mean very specific ones. In which sectors, what areas, and how can overseas business people access those opportunities?
Yeah, perhaps I can answer that in two parts, both the attractive sectors, but also some of the very attractive geographies. Because Hong Kong, as you know, is a relatively small city, 7.3 million people, right at the heart of Asia. So Hong Kong as a market is attractive in its own right, but comparatively small. So many of the companies that set up in Hong Kong are looking at opportunities in the wider region. If we look at Hong Kong itself, some of our traditional sectors continue to be very attractive. So if we look at financial services, and that includes banking, fintech, very vibrant here, something that we see good connectivity with India. Asset management also very strong, insurance still very strong, and we've got a big opportunity, we believe, around family offices. Again, something where we think there could be an opportunity for collaboration with India. The innovation and technology sector is very vibrant indeed. So four particular areas that we're focused on.
What about startups? Because startups today are looking at collaborations overseas. They're looking for funding, they're looking for partners. Can Hong Kong be of any help there?
Absolutely. So in fact, at Invest Hong Kong, we've got a dedicated startup team that works with entrepreneurs, startups and scale-ups from around the world. And there's some brilliant ones, obviously, in India. What we have seen is incredibly strong growth in the startup ecosystem in Hong Kong. So over the last 4 years, the number of startups has grown 51%. And even last year, in that incredibly difficult year for economies around the world, we saw more than 6% increase in the number of startups in Hong Kong. And 26% of startups in Hong Kong have got founders from outside Hong Kong. So is this melting pot of entrepreneurs and great businesses from around the world? Many of them are focused on those innovation-led sectors, not surprisingly, deploying technology to solve so many problems that we face. It can be in life sciences, it can be in fintech, in smart cities, tackling climate change and so forth. And also we're seeing a lot around sort of e-commerce and digital delivery more generally.
So how can people get in contact with you to take advantage of your services in this area?
Yeah, well, we have a team in Mumbai who, for any Indian company, they'd be delighted to have a chat. And our job is to help a company think about what Hong Kong might mean for them. And that could be Hong Kong, it could be Hong Kong in the context of China or wider Asia. And we'll talk through with a business or an entrepreneur where their business is, what their aspirations are, really understand their point, their positioning in the market, and then we'll provide them concrete advice as to where we think they might best place their efforts. And that will include saying, avoid doing certain things. If companies decide to move ahead, we'll introduce them to potential partners, help them with all of the nitty-gritty of setting up a business. And in the longer term, we help companies grow. So it's a long-term investment that we have with businesses, because obviously, as Hong Kong, as a city, we want companies to thrive here. So the team in Mumbai will be involved at all stages, and increasingly, they'll include colleagues based in Hong Kong who will go deeper and deeper into a particular sector. It could be a regulatory issue, a licensing issue, or it could be finding the right partners. So it's all very bespoke to the particular requirements of the business.
There's also the requirement for visas. If somebody is doing business in Hong Kong, perhaps a long-term visa, a residency, or perhaps even an immigrant visa. Is that something that Hong Kong is ready to give, or is it still a bit difficult?
I think if we look at short-term visitor visas as one category, and then longer-term visas if people are going to be based in Hong Kong. In terms of employing people, sending expatriates to Hong Kong, Invest Hong Kong can help companies through that process, working with our immigration department. And we have a number of schemes which are focused on certain types of talent, where we definitely have needs within Hong Kong. So generally speaking, that's quite a favourable environment to bring in high quality talent. In terms of short-term visitors, we know that this has been an issue for certain Indian visitors. The team in Mumbai would be happy to help if a company encounters problems. The best advice that we can give, though, is follow the guidance in terms of the required documents to the letter. Very often, the reason why an application will hit a hurdle is because somebody has tried to take shortcuts, not complied with all of the requirements, and that results in a delay. So that's my best tip.
And how about financing? Do you see an easy route for people to get financing through your services?
Certainly, we help companies find expansion capital and indeed point them in the right direction for working capital. Obviously, those decisions are at the behest of whether it's a bank or an investor, and they'll go through normal due diligence. What I would say is that there are deep pools of capital available in Hong Kong, whether debt or equity, and indeed there's lots of funding from the government side for certain types of activity. And again, we'll help companies navigate that landscape. But ultimately, it will be upon the robustness of the business whether that investment or the debt will flow, as anywhere.
Stephen, I believe you are a scuba diver and you enjoy that sport very much. How would you describe today's situation if you were to draw an analogy between scuba diving and your present day assignment? Is it like you are swimming in difficult waters and you see sharks where there aren't supposed to be sharks?
That's a very interesting question. I would say that it's diving in a swift current, which requires quite a lot of technical skill, actually. You can go with the current and you can have a brilliant dive. If you start to go against the current, then You can have a bit of a topsy-turvy ride. And COVID is that desperately strong current against which we're all sort of swimming against. But generally speaking, I think that the tide is beginning to turn. The current is moderating, and I think as we see more vaccinations being rolled out around the world, that we're going to have a much more calm, restful dive, which is my preferred way of diving, to be honest.
Well, we wish you luck, Stephen, with your diving and your assignment. Thank you for sharing your views with us.
Thank you very much indeed.